Hi everyone, welcome back to Rooted Accounting and CFO Solutions. Are you tired of creating manual invoices every single month? If so, you're in the right place. Today, we're going to walk through how to create recurring transactions using QuickBooks Online. This is a great tool for businesses who have recurring customers or recurring subscriptions. So let's dive in and make your billing process so much more efficient.
Okay, let's go ahead and get started. So you'll want to log into your QuickBooks Online account and go straight to your main dashboard. Today, we'll just be working on a sample company. Next, you want to navigate to the upper right-hand corner of the screen and click on this gear icon. This will give you a number of options to choose from, and we want to look at the list column and select recurring transactions. This is where you can create and manage all of your automated transactions. From here, you'll see any transactions you've already created, but for today's purpose, we want to create a new one. So we'll click on the new button in the far right-hand corner. And then on transaction type, because we're looking at invoices, today we'll select invoice. Next, this is where you'll fill out all the details of your recurring invoice. So first, you want to give your template a name. Because we're working in a sample company, I'll just name this weekly gardening services, but you can name it whatever works best for you. Next, you'll want to select your type. For our purposes, we want to select scheduled because this will create an automatically scheduled invoice that we'll send out to our customer on the interval that we want it to send. However, there are other options you can choose from. Reminder will just give you a reminder, instead of actually scheduling the invoice. And an unscheduled invoice can be helpful because it will automatically create the invoice. But if there's something in there that you need to change, whether it's the specific products, number of services, the total amount, you can change that. But it is helpful to have that automatically created so you don't have to fill out all the rest of the information. So today we'll select scheduled, create 0 days in advance. And then next you want to choose the customer that you're creating this invoice for. So we'll just pick one since this is just a test in our sample environment. Next, you'll want to choose from the options. For our purposes, you'll want to automatically send the email. This means that it will automatically send directly to your customer in the interval that you choose. You can also choose to print later. And additionally, if you want to include any other unbilled charges automatically in the invoice, anything that's outstanding, you can do that as well. But for today, we're just going to create a standard invoice. So next, you'll want to pick the interval that you want to send. In our case, we'll choose weekly, but you can also choose daily, monthly, or annually, whatever works for you and how often you bill your customer. Next, you'll choose how often you want to send. In our case, it's every single week. Pick the day that you want to send and then the start date. So for our case, we'll just say it starts next month in September. And you can pick an end date. For example, if your customer signs up for an annual service, you can always set the end date to the end of the year so that when it sends, it'll automatically send every single week or every single month for those full 12 months. And then next, you want to scroll down, input any of your services or your products, make sure that you include the quantity, the rate, and the total amount looks correct to you. If you have discounts or need to add sales tax, you can do that as well. And then when you're finished, you'll just go ahead and click Save Template. So now you'll see that our new invoice is here in our list of recurring transactions, and it'll give you the next date when your first invoice will be automatically sent to that customer. Once you've filled out all those details, everything should be ready to go, and you should start sending those invoices on the next occurrence. To manage your invoices, you can go to this screen at any time. If you need to go in and edit, you can do that. You can also duplicate the template if you have another customer that has similar transactions that you want to just copy and paste and then maybe update a couple details. If you need to pause or skip the next invoice, you can do that as well. There's a lot of different options, so it's a great tool to use.
And that's it. You've successfully set up a recurring invoice in QuickBooks Online. This should help you a lot going forward and make sure that you never miss an invoice. If you found this video helpful, be sure to give it a thumbs up, leave any comments below with questions you have, and follow us for future tips and tricks on QuickBooks. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.